guys working kind of late tonight, so I thought I'd give you a look at what I'm working on. We have a rack here with a number of HDMI or DisplayPort video sources that we need to convert to SDI, but also still output the HDMI. We basically need to embed an SDI version into our video system. And so what we've done is we took this rack of Decimator 12G crosses, and this is a USB hub. This connects to our engineering PC, and each of these 12G crosses has a different name assigned to it. That way, instead of trying to reach in here and read what it says, you can go down here to the PC and pull up whichever one you want according to the label. You can change everything in the software that you can on the device itself. Plus, we have this PC connected to a KVM switcher right here, so we can actually access this PC from anywhere in the building that has a KVM receiver. That means you can work on these and change any settings that you need to from anywhere that you have a KVM.
So I just deleted a couple videos and I want to talk about why. There was no content worth remembering. It was just a throwaway comment about how this TV uses more energy than the James Webb Space Telescope. Not even factually true. What most people wanted to argue about was my use of the terms kilowatt hours and watts and their relationship to each other. I understand the difference. I don't really care, but I understand. What I care about is that nobody seems to be able to read a comment and find out whether or not somebody else has told me already that I'm wrong. I wasn't. But if I were, I don't actually want 20 people telling me the exact same thing and showing that they really don't care about this at all other than to tell me that I'm wrong. It really makes creating content no fun at all. Because half of my videos have to be spent hedging against all the know-it-alls who are going to come into my comments telling me that I'm a hack. I don't mind being told I'm wrong when I'm wrong, but at least show that you actually care about the conversation.
I need to let you go. Your eyes, they shine so bright. I wanna say that line. I can't escape this now unless you show me how. It's where my demons hide. It's where my demons hide.
I feel like this is a trap. I feel like you're asking this because you've done it and you just want to trick me into saying it's not possible. Here's the thing. I can find on the internet examples of people running cameras at like 500 feet of cat cable. That's not the spec. 1,000 feet, I would really be surprised if there was any way to make that work. But, you know, I haven't actually been doing this that long. So maybe there's somebody out there who has an idea to make that work. What I will say is that if I were in charge of this installation, I would use the existing cat cable as a pull string for new fiber, and I would do it that way. If you do manage to get it to work, it's going to be with a very low resolution camera, using extremely low bandwidth, and I wouldn't count on being able to use PoE. But you know, I'm sure I've got people in the comments who are going to tell you that it is possible, and they're probably going to tell you how. So keep an eye out there and maybe we'll find out.
Yeah, so when I graduated, I didn't really want to make a career out of what I had majored in, which was religious studies. I've been running sound for bands and music stuff since I was a kid. I thought about doing work with the Stagehands Union, but I wasn't interested in a 6-year program that would mostly consist of me pushing boxes. So I looked into installation, and it turns out we have a couple really good companies here in Indianapolis. One of them was hiring at the time. They did want me to be a little bit more qualified in the industry than I already was, so I took a 12-week course with an organization called CEDIA, and I got my ESPA EST and my CEDIA, well, it's called CSIT now. At the time, it was CST. When I started at the company, they paid for me to get my AVIXA CTS certification, and from there, it was mostly hands-on, on-the-job experience. My actual job title is field technician or service technician, depends on what I'm doing that day. So yeah, if you have any other questions, feel free to ask.